These were boxes that were impounded from different hospitals and clinics here in northern Uganda. The most affected district is Kitgum, where about 1.5 billion worth of medical equipment and medicines was stolen and sold in private clinics.
The National Drug Authority head of enforcement led the operation in 17 districts of Lango and Acholi subregions.
The medicines of government of Uganda will go through the process, the court process, where we shall take their chosen persons before the magistrate, tender in the medicines, and apply to court to return the medicines to the hospital for use.
The majority of the drugs were stolen by medical workers at Kitgum General Hospital.
And as you know, malaria constitutes the biggest burden. Once in a while, sometimes we see stock out when prescriptions are being made. So we think, and I believe, the vice has impacted negatively. But from next week, there's going to be a thorough audit, which is going to take at least 5 days.
The cost of medicines and medical equipment stolen from Kitgum General Hospital is estimated at 1.5 billion shillings.
Little did we know that much was going until when the authority discovered that so many drugs were stolen. We had glimpses of many things taking place, but with involvement with other stakeholders, finally the National Drug Authority came out with the information that much drugs were stolen from our health units. As the LC5 chairperson, and to that effect, I want to take responsibility for the mess that is there. What I want to point out is that we are working very closely with the team so that the process of investigation is expeditiously handled and the culprits are brought to books.
And what I know, this land is not much. It's about 120 something there. Yeah, so this is my advice. Let us cooperate.
Classified drugs such as paracetamol worth 204 million shillings were impounded from drug shops. The main drugs that were stolen are malarials and anesthetics, which are used during surgeries. The suspects, Watmon Kenneth, Robert Akena, Rubankene James, Odong Christopher Langoya, and gynecologist Dr. Alobo Kastoni, a lecturer at Lira University, were arrested.
Two cases were opened at both Gulu and Kitgum police stations under SD 54 of 25th October 2022.
The drugs and the medical equipment are stolen by medical staff who stock them in their private clinics and pharmacies.
The suspects have been charged with unlawful possession of classified drugs and unlawful possession of government stores and carrying out a pharmacy plus abuse of office.
We have managed to successfully have around two categories of persons already arrested, because really it doesn't make sense that drugs which are meant for the population are picked by a few individuals and taken, like the case of Kitgum.
After the operation, 830 outlets of both human and veterinary drugs in the 17 districts in northern Uganda were temporarily closed.
We have queries on human drug shop, total of 125, where some of the in charges are supervising more than one. And then for the case of veterinary drug shop, some of the in charges are not registered with Uganda Veterinary Board.
It is really something that I feel bad about it, and I have to apologize to Uganda. We are supposed to protect them. We say we protect lives and properties, but now how do you protect lives when drugs which are supposed to treat their diseases they have is being stolen under our watch?
2,181 drug shops were licensed in 2021. Drug shops operating in the city are currently paying 165,000 for a license.
Every day, around 320 Ugandans die of malaria. Majority of these are children below 5 years. If the government fails to put a stop to the stealing of drugs in public hospitals, the situation could get worse. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.